Hey guys, what's up? This is Nick from RC Asteria. So, yesterday I did a video on how to fix a stripped out screw on an RC car. And so I've got quite a few of those on here, and today I'm just trying to get this truck fixed up a little bit. So the first thing we need to do is, well, I'm not going to be doing that first, but this is one of the things we need to do. We need to see this spur gear right here, it's stripped out, this slipper clutch gear. So I'm not sure which one to put on. 50 tooth, and then this is the 54 tooth. So I'm not sure which one I'll put on yet. I'll figure that out once I get to it. So guys, we've got a lot of strip screws to deal with, and lots. So that's what we're gonna try to do. And I need to get this this gear right here off the motor. I need to get a little grub screw and put it in there because that one fell out when it was running. I need to grab some Loctite and put it in there too. So let's get to it. So guys, the first thing I'm gonna do is this. There's a strip screw right here, and I'm gonna use the saw to try to get that out. So I'm gonna try to get this on camera for you guys, but it's kind of hard to do it when you're by yourself. Alright guys, so I've cut it a little bit more. I need to get me a Dremel tool one of these days so it'll be a little faster. I think this will work right here. It's deep enough. There we go. Broke loose instantly. I think this is the best method to get a strip screw out. I need to get me a new aluminum one like this because the other one, I don't know what happened, but somewhere in here, this little thingamajigger came off and it popped out. So I'm gonna have to get, and I lost the rod for it and everything, so I'm gonna have to get a new one. I've been using this plastic one. So, alright, what are we doing next? So I'm gonna take this shock tower off real quick. Alright guys, so we got this, my Intigy shock tower off, and we might as well open the diff up and re-oil it. I can make a video about that if you guys want to see that later, but I'm not going to go too in-depth today. Ooh, this bearing. That's not good, guys. Look at that. This bearing is done. Yeah, I'm going to have to get some new bearings. This bearing is toast. It doesn't even spin anymore. And you can tell where it's scratched the crap out of this thing. I may need a new one of these too, just because of that. Make sure you guys do maintenance on your trucks. I didn't do very much maintenance to this, except like once a month I'd tear it all apart, clean it, and re-grease everything. But so we are on the slipper clutch. And is this the right size? Yeah. Well, I should probably do that first. How do we do that? I need me a wrench. You know, I'll just use pliers, whatever. Okay. I'm pretty sure this is how you do this. I haven't worked on it in a long time. I'm always working on two-wheel drives because that's what he has. Wow, this clutch is tight. Jeez. Alright. And my hands are all greasy now. Oh, duh. There's a freaking grub screw on there. I am so stupid. I haven't worked on one of these in a while. Ooh, no. Please don't strip out. Not now. Not now, please. These are the worst to get out, guys, when they're stripped out. Oh, it's gonna strip out. I can feel it. It's stripped out. This is what makes me not want to even work on this truck anymore, to be honest with you guys. It's just such a pain in the butt. Okay, so here's the differential. It's actually looking pretty nice, except for this bearing. No, that's good. This bearing's good too. Alright, I'm gonna have to pull these screws out. I'm gonna have to find a really teeny tiny Allen wrench, Allen key to get that out. You know, I'm not even gonna do that. I'm just gonna clean this diff off and put some new grease in it. I'm not gonna go too in depth with it. I'll make another video on that. And I'm just gonna wipe most of it off, not all of it. There's also oil inside these differentials too that you gotta do, which I've done. I'm gonna listen to this real quick and make sure there's no weird sounds in the differential. No, I think it's good, no clicks or nothing. Alright, so I'm gonna set this over here. So we gotta get this motor out. And just go just like this, right? Yep, just like that. Plus it loose. And there it is. The Valenian motor, and I better unplug these. Alright. Let's take this ESC out. I think it's funny when people call them ESCs. Makes me laugh. I was watching a video on how to program an ESC or whatever, and he's like, so you gotta program the ESC. Will any of these work? Oh yeah, there we go. Alright, I'm gonna unscrew this electronic box and I'll be back when it's done. Alright guys, I got all the screws out of there. And this doesn't look very good. It looks like we got some dust in here. If dust can get in here, that means water can get in here, so that's not good at all. But I'm not planning on driving this in any crazy snow or water or anything like that. I pulled the right one? Of course not. This is the right one. Okay. These are a little bit of a pain to get out, especially if you have this thing over here, like moved over a little bit. You can't get them out. You have to pull it out, pull this whole thing out, and you can't shut the lid if it's like that either. Okay, so we got the ESC out. So I think this is about as far as I'm gonna go. I'm gonna tear the front end down today too with you guys, and then tomorrow. Well, I can't film it all tomorrow because I'll be going to a funeral. But the day after that, if I can, or the day after that, if I can do it, I will come and film the second part of this. Alright, I think that's dry. So let's try it. We are screwed with that. Guys, just try to keep from stripping these out. These are the worst, man. Do not strip a grub screw out. And they're the easiest to strip out, too. But anyways, let me get to tearing this down. I'll work on that later. Maybe off screen. Maybe I'll even make a separate video about that. But I need to clean my driver off right here because it's got a bunch of super glue on it. Alright, it's clean. I hope this ain't stripped either. And it is. That's just amazing. How many stripped screws I have. This one's stripped out too. I don't even know how this happens, to be honest. I think it's because I'm not using the perfect tools. I'm using Torx. I'm not using, like, hexes. But anyways, I'm going to cut these up right here. And, well, I'm going to try the wires first because that'll be easier. But anyways, if that doesn't work, then I'll come back, and these will be have slots cut in them, and I'll try to open them up. Alright guys, so I've got these cut out, these strips, these things right here, or whatever. And I made sure that they fit, so I'm going to try to work them out. Alright, I'm going to have to cut that one more, so I'm going to try this one. Good. This one comes off. Alright, I'm going to cut this one a little bit more. And I will be back. Alright guys, I've cut it a little bit more. See if we can work it out. Strip screws are such a pain. hand is killing me now. Not my hand, but these tendons right here, because I'm squeezing so hard trying to open this thing. God, how tight is this, dude? Jesus. I don't know if we'll be able to get this one out. Darn it, guys. I don't know if this one's gonna come out. Whatever. Alright, so I think I've had enough for today. I'm gonna end it today. And I'll be back in the next video. Please like, comment, subscribe, as always. Goal 100 subscribers by the end of this year. And thanks for watching. See ya.